Right, so folks, we're at Pamukkale in Turkey now. So we've driven from Cappadocia and we're coming, driving to Marmaris, and we stopped off at Pamukkale. These are the natural thermal salt waters, full of calcium, like all of the hills. Look, it's amazing. This is all calcium. These are thermal enriched pools. So yeah, you can walk down this path and enter a lot of the pools, go in them. It's really cool. Look at that view. So look at that sunset, folks. They're like little infinity pools all the way down. So we came from up there. So originally, apparently, all of these would have been filled and they've all been like more turquoise colour, but I think it just got destroyed over the years by the tourists, so you're only allowed in certain areas, but the water doesn't flow everywhere now. Beautiful though. It's about £10 to get in, that's all. So here I am, folks, in continuing in Pamukkale. So I was explaining earlier, all of this white stuff you see here, it's all calcium basically. The water used to flow, like I was saying earlier, in most places, but apparently they redirected the water years ago for the town down there. And look at that sunset. And something to do with, it's either, this fear is, it's apparently it's either the redirection of the water or some, because the water comes from underground, or some earthquake. So the water flow, natural water flow, has stopped. So all of this you see, if you see it over there, that's all pumped in now. It's really warm, but it's all pumped in. It's not natural anymore. It used to be all like this, look, you see it flowing. All over these infinity pools. It's amazing. So it used to be all like this, but unfortunately, over time with tourists and, you know, human intervention, I think a lot of it has taken that away, but it's still a beautiful and amazing place to visit. It's Turkey's really good. I mean, I recommend Turkey. There's some amazing places here, and this is definitely worth seeing just to come and relax and catch the sunset. Look at that. Amazing. From further up, folks, this is the water I was saying about that's pumped down, and that's some of the infinity pools down the bottom. Nice turquoise colour, look. Pretty nice. Beautiful here. That water is like really warm. And yeah, it just goes all the way up like this. This is calcium hills, it's like a white castle. Hello. Hello. Sind aber. Dafür hat Stuschemauer. Hat Stuschemauer.
I'm trying to do with you again.
That's a bit extreme.
Yeah. Nah, I feel.
That's fair enough.
I feel my throat a bit.
Yeah? Probably not then, because it's cold.
Yeah.
It's fine when you're in, but it is cold when you first go. Do you want the rope? I'll swing it to you.
Like a jump again? Don't jump on your back.
That didn't quite work, did it?
I'm in the water now, folks. Look. In the water. This is Tupala Waterfalls in Mogla. It's in Turkey, near Marmaris. So I'm in the water. Check out how clear that is. Look, you can see the bottom. Crazy. It's beautiful here. I'm not sure if my phone's waterproof, but it's fine. So we hiked up to here, small hike, in this fresh, clean, beautiful water.
So much down for that. Jenny Trasco.
Yeah.
Woo!
Have a view from Topala waterfall. It's amazing. Look at that water. So we was just on that rope swing, jumping into the water, swinging in, should I say. It's like fishing there as well. It's so cool. Another great experience. We've got it all to ourselves as well. There were people here, but they've left. So we had to walk up there. Madness.
Folks, today's the day. I'm doing paragliding, 2,000 meters in the air. It's fucking mental, excuse my language, and I am very nervous. But it's got to be done. Can't let nerves take over. Look at that. So yeah, loads of people do it. So we're doing it over the Blue Lagoon in Turkey. It's a 45-minute flight, apparently. There's that platform there is where you run and take off from, basically. Doesn't feel as bad because it's like a slight incline there. But yeah, so I'll be getting as much footage as I can. They land, folks. That's where I landed as well. You see, one's coming in now. So you just land literally on this patch of grass here. So he's just coming now. Look at that. Perfect landing. There's another one coming in there. And look at them all in the sky. Look, everywhere. That's the bit I landed over there. crazy. They're all up there as well, look, everywhere. I counted like 30 odds in the sky earlier. I mean, it's just continuous all day. It's like all day thing. So folks, come to Rhodes, Greece for the day. So we're in, I think the camera's a bit dirty. Yeah, so just gonna explore the island for the day. We've got a boat from Marmaris to Rhodes, which is 1 hour. And we're just gonna explore, and we're going into the castle. Looks nice. Beautiful here. I stand corrected, it's a palace, not a castle. So just walking up the stairs now. Look at that mosaic. You're not allowed to walk on there to preserve it, but look at that. Impressive. There's another one over here. There's a little right up there. It's so quiet in here. Where is he? Like to explore there. Look at those vaulted ceilings. Wow. Oh, look, excavating that. Oh, look at that. So look, this is what's underneath the floor they've excavated. That's crazy. So many mosaics here. Well preserved. These rooms have more decor on, so I'm assuming they're living quarters. Mosaics are nicer, walls are papered or painted. It's really nice. Wow, look at that room. You can see that, probably not. Some of this furniture must be so old. Crazy place.
That's amazing. That lamp. So you can understand why they don't let you walk on it. There's parts, I don't know if it shows in the camera, but there are parts where, am I looking at there, you see? That have worn out where people walk on them. So you can understand the other room was worse, why people don't let you walk on them. Because with the thousands of visitors, there'll be nothing left. So quiet. And then I turn up and start shouting whilst I'm filming. It's really weird, the contrast between Turkey and Greece, you know, European to non-European, westernised. It's and it's just like an hour away, it's so different. The everything's just so different here. I hope you're enjoying the video so far. Because I wasn't going to film, and then I decided to film. Because it's pretty cool. This is the courtyard in between, so I'm not sure how good the video is because I actually broke my camera on holiday. Well, I haven't broke it as such, it's just broken one of the I'll show you actually. So if I zoom in or out to a certain percentage, it's fine, but if I don't, this is what you see. Hold on, we'll get there. You go. Oh, it's typical, isn't it? Can't see it now. Anyway, there we go. See that? That's what you see, and it's worse. So that's what I see. So I have to zoom out or in to get good footage. But I don't know if it's as good as what it could be. So I need to look at it when I get home. It's just, it's like this. I don't know. It's not a crack. I'm not sure what's wrong with it. But anyway, it is what it is. Could be worse. But yeah, this is the courtyard. So folks, it's called the Palace of the Grand Master. Now I've actually got the name and before I started recording, I should have said, found out. Beautiful building. It is really nice. Definitely worth seeing. It was combined ticket with the archaeological museum, it's €10 a person, so that's pretty good. Or just €8 per person if you want to go in there. So yeah, it's quite good. So just found out after queuing up for ages, got a ticket, didn't tell us that the wall was included. So it's like another 4 mile queue again. So I just skipped and went up to the front. I said, it's not fair to make us queue and you're not telling us a separate ticket. Because we bought a combined ticket, so you assume that's for everything. Apparently not. Failed to mention that, so I went to the front and we got the tickets. And now we're on the wall of the palace. So we get to walk around the whole wall, so that's really cool. I really wanted to do that. So it's €3 for that. So it's 26 combined for everything in total for two people. It's not bad.
So this is the wall, folks. It's really cool. So you get a little bit of a higher perspective of roads as well. Get over there. I mean, I could climb the railings, which I would do if it wasn't just me doing it, but I don't think my wife will be climbing railings with me, so yeah. And that's part of roads, folks. It's quite really nice here. I'd actually come back quite long, actually. It's much more than I expected. These walls are huge. It's definitely worth €3. And then look how thick they are. I'm not sure if there's like something underneath, like in between, but it seems like there's quite a lot that you can't actually get to and see. But I really recommend coming on these walls if you're in Rhodes and that palace. It's a dungeon. Oh wow. Yes, so there is stuff underneath. Look. Look at that. Wow. Really thick. Or maybe it is hollow inside, I'm not sure. Oh, look at that. It's amazing. So this is like a turret that sticks out. Some nice views. See, look, it's huge, really huge. Amazing. Just unfortunately, you can't get to all of it, but definitely a lack of maintenance here. Look at it, it's just a shame they can't look after it a bit, preserve it, and stop it getting any worse, because there's a lot more areas you could see if they just looked after it. It's just, look at it. Shame, really. You know, they could put a good wooden platform over here to protect the rest of the floor, for example. But I suppose it's money, isn't it? It costs a lot of money. So I can kind of understand. Wooden cracks. Crazy. Just walk from right over there. And doors lead to. Wow. So, this is the archaeological museum. Really nice. Thank you. These are the normal streets of Rhodes, how the shops are. Very busy. It's the harbour.
Which one was the other one?
I'm leaving Rhodes, folks. Beautiful, look at that water. Got to get the boat back now to Marmaris. So, really nice. Definitely showed me I would come back for an actual holiday here rather than just a day, you know. I almost forgot to vlog, folks. So we're in Ephesus, if I've pronounced that right, in Turkey. It's amazing. Apparently it's the second biggest place during the Roman times where people lived. Quite a lot of people. I don't have too much information, just because to be honest, I didn't know much about it before I came here, so it's amazing. Look at that. Actually allowed to walk here as well, it's crazy. It's really impressive. The guy was saying though that this is bigger, this place, than Pompeii, and it's only 20% excavated, so massive, huge. Yeah, that's really cool. Assume we're in like an amphitheatre, something like that. So cool. Yeah, I'll continue on, folks, when I move on. Amazing, after this is still quite a lot still standing. That arch you see there, I'll zoom in. That's just up by its own weight. There's no mortar, no pegs, nothing. It's just its own weight holding it together. Pretty impressive, to be honest. Wow. So impressive. Apparently it says my device is too hot, the video quality may be affected, so I apologise. It's in the sun, so not much I can do about that. Wow, it's impressive. Thank you. the writing on there, still so clear. Looks like they've reconstructed a part of that.
Thank you so much.
Oh, look at that. The main event, folks. As there's not too many people down there now, I'm going to head down that way and come back up here. There's lots of other little bits off on the side, but it doesn't seem too busy down there. And there's huge groups about to head that way. So I'll come back here, I think. Wow. That's impressive. Reminds me of Petra, very similar. That. That's just where we're walking down. You can see where the streets used to be. It's crazy. So here we are, folks. Look at that. Ooh, wow. So I can't zoom the camera out anymore because it's broken. Not sure what's wrong with it, so I pretty much have to stay at this setting. But look at that. You can see where they've added a couple of bits to keep it standing, but that's impressive. And it's really cool you can actually walk up there, because in Petra you can only kind of see it from the outside, although there's not much inside, you can't go anyway. Look at that. Look at the detail. That is impressive. Wow. Just gonna do a quick walk of those people right there. The inside of it. Impressive. Amazing. Really amazing. Look at that. It's amazing. Crazy. It's huge, this place. Oh, shame that's closed. Right, look at that. It's another amphitheatre. It's huge. It's a huge crane there, so it looks as though they're renovating parts of it or maybe making it more stable so it doesn't fall or get any worse. But it's massive. It's huge.